Look, maybe you two should sit down, reminisce about 20th century wish I could. Bye.
Bye.
Janie Blumberg. Is your brother Ben Blumberg?
Yep, that's her brother Ben.
I went to Camp Two Blitz with Ben Blumberg when I was 9.
Yep, that's my brother, Ben.
Would you tell your brother Murray Schlunovitz says hello?
Who is Murray Schlunovitz?
Me. Well, before my father owned the Sterling Taverns, he owned the Schlunovitz kosher dairy restaurants in Brooklyn. But about 15 years ago, all the Schlunovitz restaurants burned down. So for the sake of the business of the family, we changed all our names before I entered Harvard. Well, nice to see you. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. What were you doing? Maybe you two should sit and reminisce about 20th century problems.
Marty Sterling could make a girl a nice husband.
Now you really sound like your mother.
Patty, do you know who that man's father is?
Uh-huh, he's an arsonist.
No, he's a genius. Mr. Sterling, the little man who comes on TV in a colonial suit and a pilgrim hat to let you know he's giving away all the shrimp you can eat and free popovers at ye old salmon and relish bar? That man is Milky Schlunovitz, Marty Sterling's father.
It's all right, I can make do without Dr. Murray Marty and his father's popovers. I have to get back to Colgate for a second interview. My friend Joe Stein said that they only ask you back if they're going to hire you.
Well, if you don't marry Marty Sterling, I will. Wait till I tell my parents I ran into them. Tasha Blumberg will have the caterers on the other extension.
I'm afraid marrying him is not a solution. Will you walk me back to Colgate?
Sure, if I can get myself up.
Do I look like a successful single woman?
Well,
what?
Harry, you know the wisdom of Tasha Blumberg?
Wish it could be one.
Always look nice when you take out the garbage. You never know who you might meet. Put on your jacket, sweetheart. Always stand with your head up and your chest out. Think, I am.
I am.
Now I can be seen with you.
Julie Stern at Women's Work Magazine. We've read your portfolio. Our readers feel you haven't experienced enough women's pain to stimulate our market. Thank you.
Amy, it's Cynthia. There's a Link Men, Link Women mixer at the Unitarian Church on Friday. It got a 4-star rating in Wisdom's Child. My cousin Felice met an anthropologist there, and she's in much worse shape than either of us. Wanna go?
Isn't that nice? You can have breakfast with me and your father. Janie. People who wait, wait. I like go, go. What? I say head to and up, and up, and up, and up. The girls at dance school would learn so much. They tell me they wish their mothers had so much energy.
Their mothers probably wear clothes.
Why are you so modest?
I'm your daughter. I shouldn't be seeing you in leopard print underwear.
You're making fun of me again.
I'm not making fun of you. Where's Dad?
I sent him to pick up some coffee.
Do the girls at dancing think it's strange you order a breakfast from a coffee shop every morning?
Sweetheart, when you get married, you make breakfast at your house and invite me. Anything you make is fine. You want to make sausages, I'll eat sausages. Oh, do you know what sausages are made of? Janie, please don't mind their left body. You have everything to look forward to. You know, when you were in high school, the other mothers would stop me on the street and they would say, you must be so proud of Janie. She's such a brilliant child. If only my daughters were like Janie.
What are the names of these mothers? I want names.
Is your father with the coffee?
Janie, is this place safe for you? There isn't even a doorman. Why don't you put in that lock in Brooklyn?
I left it there.
You left it in Brooklyn? That lock must be $50.
I have it, Dad. I have
it. You want to split this sandwich with me?
Simon, please. There's a proper way to do this. First, we have to toast Janie's new apartment. I remember my first apartment in New York. Of course, I was much younger than you when I was married to your father. To Janie. Congratulations, welcome home. And I hope next year you live in another apartment and your father and I have to bring up four apartments.
You want me to have a roommate?
I want you to be happy. Simon, talk to her like a father and a daughter. Maybe she wants to tell you her problems.
I don't have any problems. How's the business, Dad?
Your father's always with the business. You want to see something, Janie? Smell this.
It's nice.
And I can't make them fast enough. Then those jerks send me a million copies without any perfume. You know what that's gonna do to the Valentine season? Your father always with the headaches.
It's all right, Dad. I like the envelope. Smells like a skater man.
Do you want to come down to work and see whether it interests you? And then I'll take you skating.
I can't today, Dad. I gotta follow up some leads for some clients. Some other time I'd like to.
Is that an outfit? Simon, from a man's point of view, is that what you call an appetizing outfit?
Janie, if you like your brother Ben, then I can understand going out on your own. But I don't understand why a woman with your intelligence is freelance writing when she can take over an entire business.
Christ is thinking of going to law school when the kids get a little older.
Who?
Your sister-in-law, Christ.
Chrisma, it's Chris.
Too big to it. If not today, tomorrow. I can't sit like you two. Head up, head down, head up, head
down. I won't say it. Don't ask me.
Look at those ties. Dying.
What's his name called? They're not looking for you.
Who? Who?
That popover boy. He called Ben because we went to summer camp together, and Ben didn't have your new number, so he told him to call us.
Ben told Marty Sterling to call you.
Please, sweetheart. Look nice. It's important. Even when you throw out the garbage. I like this Marty Sterling.
You don't even know him.
He comes from good people.
His father is an arsonist.
Believe me, you have a nice life with him. Sounds like a very nice boy. He left a message for you to call him at the hospital. He was in the emergency room and now it's Sinai.
I told you he comes from good people.
Don't get too excited. He probably wants Harriet.
What does Harry have to do with the Popover boy?
He's her friend.
Why must you believe yourself like that? What kind of attitude is that? How come you can't walk into a room with your head up and your chest out and think, I am. Am I right, Simon?
What is it?
Would you stop looking at those envelopes and look at your daughter? From a man's point of view, is that some beautiful face?
I am beautiful. People stop each other on the street to say how beautiful I look when I throw out the garbage. I was still in Brookline, I'd be sleeping. Here by 7:15, I get a catered meal and a floor chef.
Oh, you can always have a good time with Tasha. Honey, it was great to see you. I loved your cooking. And I know you'd like me to stay in chat all day and stuff, but your father isn't the only one who has to go to work. I'm demonstrating in class today.
Goodbye, Jane.
Where are you going? Would you give her some money so she can buy a lot?
Jeannie, I'm sorry for this job. Mother walks to work every morning now. Once I walk a few blocks, my mind gets stimulated. You know, Jeannie, I just have the same problem with my legs as you do. I have to sit in bed and wrestle. You know what makes a difference? Ripple soles. Get a pair of shoes like these, and then you're in business.
So you'll call us Marty Sterling?
I'll call him I am the call.
Am I getting shorter? I'm getting shorter.
Fine, Mother.
Daddy, please don't get back into the bed. You have everything ahead of you. You can have a family, you can have a career, and you can learn to tap dance.
Are you taking tap dancing?
It's part of life, I'll teach you.
I told your mother she can open up her own dancing school.
Flat, heel. Flat, heel. Flat, heel. Two lessons!
Don't think Mother looks nice? That's new attaché case.
I'm an executive, Mother.
She looks very nice.
You like it?
Yes, I like it.
You want it?
You keep it, Mother.
Let's go, dear. Remember, Jane. Ripple souls.
Right. Jane, please. Only old ladies size. Like you.
Jane!
He's back in New York, and that's nice. I see my friend Joe Stein, the headhunter.
Nice boy.
Nice. A little dull.
Sweet, though. No, you're right, a little dull.
And I'm sort of interested in some guy in my office.
Is that a good idea?
Well, I'm not seeing him. I'm just attracted to him.
Sounds like a pleasant arrangement. What does he do?
Mother?
His job, baby. What does he do?
He's my boss's boss.
How old is he?
Around 40.
Around 40? He should be further along than your boss's boss.
Happy birthday, Mother.
You can ask me questions about my life right after I'm finished with yours. You're not making this easy, baby.
Sometimes you're hard to take, Mother.
So they say. Yes, Bill? Oh, Bill, my daughter's with me. Is it all right if she's present at this meeting? I thought so. Thanks, Bill. It's a birthday thing. Harry, why don't you come with me? You can be my date.
Mother, I remember when he used to take me to group sales meetings in Barbados. And I would appear in my Mary Jane's as your date for candlelit the dinners by the ocean.
You were a wonderful date. Interesting, attractive, bright. Certainly more suitable than what was available.
Mother, you're so crazy. I hope I'm going to be all right.
You'll be fine. Don't dwell on it. Your generation is absolutely fascinated with itself. Think about science. Technology is going to change our world significantly. So, do you want to come?
Sure.
God, I dread going to these kinds of things.
Me too.
I'm not being too harsh.
No, you're not being too harsh.
Comb your hair, baby. I like it better off your face.
The young ones, though. The people my age intimidate me.
only Jewish family should have at least three children.
Excuse me?
The dying religion. Intermarriage, Ivy League colleges, Europe Review of Books. So how's Harriet?
She's fine.
Sounds sweet like you.
Harriet is wonderful.
Like those medical school girls. They're nice, but they bite your balls off. You think Israelis have a sense of humor? Believe me, women medical students are worse. Danny, one of the few real people I've ever met in a long time. Most of the women I meet aren't funny.
Marty, I think I should tell you I find the fact you don't like women doctors extremely disturbing and discriminatory. I support the concept of Israel and would probably be a much happier, healthier person if I could go out into the desert and build forests. But I'm far too lazy and self-involved. I have fat thighs, and I want very badly to be someone else without going through the effort of actually changing myself into someone else. I have very little courage, but I'm highly critical of others who don't.
Is that it?
And I want you to like me very much.
You like me?
Yes.
Sounds tentative. Most women fall in love the minute they hear Valara. Maybe this will help. I bought it for you when I was in Rome.
I was wondering why they had swizzle sticks in the wine.
I got connections to the restaurant business.
Should I take you home now, Rocky?
What?
You want to go home?
No. My interior decorator is there.
I'll come to my parents' house. They should be out late tonight. After Paramus, there's a UJA testimonial dinner for my father. It means a lot to him because he's been giving away so much shrimp at the salad bar, they almost revoked his job as postmaster.
We're going to someone else's parents' house. Should we have mortgages and children?
Let's go. Kill me. I'll help you.
And what'll I do for you?
Be sweet. I need attention.
A great deal of attention.
Baby, I bet you do.
Do you like me to spoil you a bit?
Relax. For a girl with such a good mind, you get tense too easily. Why are you laughing?
You're amazing. First you tell me how amusing I am, and then you tell me you want to spoil me. And now you tell me the great mind I have. What are you going to do next? Ask me up to see your etchings? Oh, I'm sorry. This just makes me all a little uncomfortable. Office romance and all that.
Harry, did you know that 40% of the people at McKinsey are having inter-office affairs?
How do you know that?
A friend of mine who studied. Look, I live with a woman, so no one will know. Is that an incentive?
Kathy. Do you live with Kathy?
How do you know Kathy?
She calls the office 3 times a day.
You've been paying attention.
I'm a smart kid.
Smart woman.
Well, I generally try not to get involved with unavailable men.
You've never been with a married man. How old?
Are you okay?
Jesus, were there any nuts in that pate? My doctor told me not to eat nuts. I've got this stomach thing. I tell you, when you get older, you really gotta watch it. But you'll take care of me, right, beauty? Are you excited? Harry, I'll be wonderful for you. You'll try to change me. You'll realize you can't. And furthermore, I'm not worth it. So you'll run off and marry some nice investment banker and make your mother happy.
I don't think my mother particularly wants me to get married. I don't particularly want me to get married.
You'll change your mind. Career girls, when they hit 30, all change their minds. Look, whatever's going on here, we better do it quickly, because Kathy's expecting me home with the laundry at 11. I'm very attracted to you, Harry.
40% of the people at McKinsey, huh?
Those are just the ones crazy enough to fill out the questionnaire.
Get out of here.
Come here. Deal from strength. Men really like strong women.
And Marty hired me to write the popovers opening remarks.
don't you mind not seeing Paul on the weekends?
No, it's all right. As I see it, Paul's doing it's fine till I can find the right relationship. It's similar to the case method. Anyway, he's great in bed.
Marty claims he slept with over 100 visiting nurses when he was at Harvard.
Really?
No, I just told you that so you'd sit down.
So, is it something with Marty?
He decided to open his practice here next month. And he's invited me to his parents' house for Hanukkah. Some days, I walk down the street and think, if I don't step on any cracks, I'll marry Marty. Whatever happened to Janie Lumber? She did so well, she married Marty, the doctor. They're giving away popovers in Paramus. Patty, do you think I should marry Marty?
I've always hated women who sit around and talk about how there are no men in New York, or everyone is gay or married.
What does this have to do with my marrying Marty?
Well, these women would tell you, marry him. He'll make a nice living, he's straight, he'll be a good father. Janie, what people like Cynthia Peterson don't know is, no matter how lonely you get, or how many birth announcements you receive, the trick is not to get frightened. There is nothing wrong with being alone.
Harriet, do you remember when we would listen to My Guy while ironing our hair before going to a high school dance?
Oh God, I've blocked all of that.
I remember arriving at the dance, looking over the prospects, and thinking, when I'm 28, I'm gonna be married and very much in love with someone who is poor and fascinating. Until he's 30, and then fabulously wealthy and very secure after that. And we're gonna have children who wear flannel shirts and overalls and are kind and independent with curly blonde hair. And we'll have great sex and still hold hands when we travel to China when we're 60.
I never thought of any of that. Maybe it's because I'm Lillian's daughter, but I never learned to respect women who didn't want to live alone and pay their own rent. Imagine spending your life pretending you weren't a person. To compromise with this one would be anti-feminist. Well, anti-humanist. Or just not impressive. Am I being too harsh?
No, just rhetorical.
Who's that?
I don't know.
Hello, hi.
Hi, Parkin.
You are Miss Bloomberg?
Yes.
What are you? I'm Vladimir, filmmaker from Moscow, and I'm taxi now. Hello, hi.
Jane, do you like this bar? Oh, hello, Harry. It's what you might need to make a home to entertain.
Don't bust, Simon. Hi, sweetheart. Harriet, you look terrific. Are you seeing anybody?
Sort of.
We met Vladimir on the cab ride down here. He came from Moscow 6 weeks ago.
That's nice. Do you like it here?
Hello, hi.
Very much English.
That doesn't matter. If you like people, you speak any language. Me? I can get along in any country. You smile, you dance, everybody will understand you.
My mother identifies with Zorba the Greek.
Oh, Zorba, yes, thank you.
Harry, do you like the bar? I saw another one, but I was afraid Janie would say it's too old, it's too new, it's gold.
Vladimir, maybe you want to stay here and put the bar together, and me and Harriet and Mrs. Blumberg will bring you up some coffee.
Oh, coffee, regular.
Harriet, sit. Join us. Harriet with Colgate Palmolive.
Janie, he's a nice boy. Seems intelligent, too. I thought maybe if things don't work out between you and Marty, I'd sort of take him into the business.
What? The man is here 6 weeks. He gets a wife, a business, and a dancing mother-in-law.
What's wrong with giving a guy a break?
Dad.
Vladimir, thank you. We'll take the cab uptown to Rockefeller Center.
Every Saturday, I take Mr. Blumberg skating.
My partner keeps me in terrific shape.
You look terrific, Harry. Who is it you're seeing again?
She's seeing someone who is married.
Let's go again.
Put a deposit down in an apartment for us in Brooklyn today.
What?
sticking for waiting for you to make up your mind to move, we'd never take anything. And you need a place to stay before I open my practice. You don't have to pay your half your deposit now, I can wait a minute. Is that okay?
Sure.
I decided we should live in Flatbush or Brighton Beach because people have real values. My father never sees these people anymore. The Alpha Happies in Brooklyn. The old man with the accents is in front of Titan's Highway Delicatessen. I miss them. My father never goes to Miami Beach anymore. We go to Palm Springs, Martinique, with a friend from the Westchester Country Club. My father thought my brother was crazy when he named his son Shlomo. He kept asking him, so what's his real name? My father will think I'm crazy when he moves to Brooklyn.
Marty.
What is it? Are you angry?
No. I like the Alpacas. I always thought Herman Wolf should write an album. Young Kappa. I don't know.
What don't you know? Janie, you're 28 years old. What I'm saying is either you want to do it, you don't have to. You should just want it. But if you don't want it, we should just forget it.
I do want to.
So what's the problem?
No problem.
Oh my God, what time is it? I promised my father we'd watch a new commercial.
This is Captain Milty Sterling. I'm here at the beautiful Green Acres Mall with the popover boy and my grandson, Shlomo.
Why are you laughing? The man is a marketing genius. He's giving away shrimp. He's giving away coleslaw. I never heard of such an incentive program. How much do you think you could give away and still make a profit? It's good, Grandpa.
Where are you going?
It's late.
You could spend the night.
Kathy.
Do you love Kathy?
She's devoted to me.
Does Kathy exist?
Of course Kathy exists.
I thought maybe Kathy was some answering service you hired to call you 3 times a day.
Didn't I tell you to deal from strength?
Yes.
Sometimes I'm a jackass. You're very sweet, you know that? You're a sweet woman. A lot of people never get off in their entire life. Do you think your mother's had good sex?
My mother likes to watch the Rogers file reruns every night. Paul, I don't think people think about sex as much as you do.
Tell me what you like, Judy.
Paul, the other day, I was by your office with my per charts, and you called your secretary, Beauty. You called whoever was on the phone, Beauty. And I think you even called the 90-year-old messenger boy from Holsby and Mather, Beauty.
I see what's going on here. It's the old, I'm afraid of turning 30 alone and beginning to think about having a family.
Wanting 2 nights a week or even a sleepover date is not quite family.
Baby, I'm older than him. I've been through this with a lot of women. You want a man who sees you as a potential mother, and someone who isn't threatened by your success, and is deeply interested in you. And this man should be thought of as intelligent by your friends. When you need him, he should drop whatever it is he's doing and be supportive.
I'm not asking for that. Why are you so bitter?
Don't be naive, Harriet. Everything's a negotiation. Everything. When I graduated from Yale, I thought I'd find a nice wife and cook me dinner. We'd have a few kids and support the family. We'd get a house up in Madison, Connecticut for the weekends. The girl I married didn't cook. And she wasn't lucky like you. Girls didn't assume they'd have careers then. She was just very smart and very unhappy. And the girls I date now, the ones like you, the MBAs from Harvard, They want me to be the life. They want me to be the support system. Well, I can't do that. I just wasn't told that was the way it was supposed to be.
Well, I don't know which way it was supposed to be.
What do you mean?
I don't expect anything from you.
Harry, you and I are a lot alike. You don't want to be alone. You don't want to move forward. So we serve a perfect function, locking each other's lives.
I like you, Bob.
My poor baby.
I'm hungry.
What do you have to eat, Nucky?
We can order up some sandwiches. I have the phone number of every coffee shop on the Upper East and West Side. The Four Brothers on the Parthenon, the Four Brothers on the Acropolis, the Four Brothers...
I'll go to the supermarket. Get some chicken and some lettuce and stuff.
No, let's just order up a salad.
You don't know how to cook a chicken?
I do. I can cook Teflon chicken.
You shouldn't put yourself down like that.
Marty, I love you. We can take the place in Brooklyn. I just want to be with you.
Wow!
class. A real workout I had today.
You look marvelous. How's Ben?
Ben is doing very well. He's a lawyer in Corvette. I mean, Craddock.
And Simon?
Simon is with his business. Oh, he would love for Janie to take over, but Janie says she's happy freelance writing.
I always liked Janie. She's such a bright girl.
I tell her people, stop me on the street and tell me how bright it is. But she doesn't believe me. Janie tells me Harry's had a nice job.
Yeah, she's with Colgate Palmolive.
Oh, she's going to be an executive mother like you. Very nice. Do you see the girls much? My daughter, whenever I call her, I get the machine.
I'd be Harriet's secretary. Or rather, my secretary, which is Harriet's secretary.
She's always been a hard worker, Harriet.
Harriet tells me Janie's seeing a nice boy.
Oh, he's a very nice boy. But so what? Harriet and Janie are nice girls. They deserve a little madness. Do you know what I mean by madness? A little happiness. Well, I don't want to keep you. I know that you're a busy woman and you probably have appointments.
Actually, I thought I'd surprise Harriet and take her to a nice lunch. But her secretary told me she was in a meeting. So I came down to the park and treated myself to a frankfurter. I haven't had a frankfurter in the park since I lived in London 30 years ago.
Can I tell you something? I'm sorry, I forgot your first name.
Lillian.
Lillian. Maybe it's none of my business. But you shouldn't eat frankfurters. Do you know what frankfurters are made of? Here. Have some string beans. All the young girls at dancing school carry plastic bags with string beans in them.
Thank you.
Oh, excuse me. I always tell my daughter that only old ladies sigh. You know, my husband has this expression. He says, everything dresses itself out. Believe me. Harriet will find a nice boy. She'll get married, she'll have a career, she'll have a wonderful life. I don't understand why we're fighting it so hard.
Well, I don't think Harriet thinks about marriage much.
Well, these days they live together. That's the latest, and believe me, the same thing as being married.
I don't think Harriet particularly wants to live with anyone. I don't want to live with anyone.
Well, you can't listen to your children all the time. My daughter tells me I don't wear clothing. I'm wearing clothing. My daughter, Janie, thinks I call her in the morning. Check up on her. This morning I call her, and she answers the phone, and she says, hello, Mother. This morning I got married, lost 20 pounds, and became a lawyer.
That's funny.
Oh, you can always have a good time with Janie. But you know what's sad? Not that like a child, still or anything. But just a little sad to me. My daughter never thinks I call her. Because I miss her. The girls at dance, they tell me about their problems. They tell me about their boyfriends and their parents. What they ate yesterday, what they're going to eat tomorrow. But they're not my children. Sure, I'd like you to be married. And if you were a lawyer, that would be nice too. And believe me, if I could take her by the hand and do it for her, I would. Because I'm happy with what I do. You know, I remember when she was in high school. And she would slam the door to her room, and she would say, Mother, what do you want from me? Lillian, what do I want from you? I just want to know that she's well, and just to give her a little push too, you know, but just a little.
Sooner or later, you can have everything pressed.
Everything presses itself out. You know, with the mother and the daughter carrying hands. Maybe your life is like that. But at 7:15 in the morning, my Janie and I don't get up to play golf together.
Harriet and I don't get up to play golf either. Do those string beans really fill you up?
You're an intelligent million. How can a bag of string beans really fill you up?
Do you ever go to Ruffle Lyons across the street?
Oh, I take my granddaughter when she's in the city.
They have the nicest stuffed animals at Rumble Myers. I never like those Stein toys that are made of Schwartz.
They're made in Germany.
How many grandchildren do you have?
Oh, just one. Well, I'm looking forward. I'll tell you what's nice about grandchildren. You don't have to worry about them every day, and they don't have to assign it. Oh, that means they don't bang in the tea kettle.
Would you care to join me at Rumpelmeyer's for a Sunday? I have 20 minutes before I have to be at a meeting. I'm sure you could get some iced coffee or some fruit.
Why should I get fruit when they have such nice ice cream? I don't care what restaurant you go to, the fresh fruit cup is never fresh.
I haven't been for a Sunday in the afternoon since I was ambassador. This is a big day for me. A Frankfurter in the park, a Sunday at Rumpelmeyer's. I'm having a wonderful time.
All the girls are dancing, so you can always have a good time with Tasha.
Do you like James Garner?
Who?
Do you ever watch the Rockford Files?
I like the television on sometimes. You know, after my classes and I'm waiting for signs to come home from work. But I don't really like it. Educational broadcasting and the Barbara Walters specials. Did you see that long last week with Richard Nixon? That man did all right for himself.
I beg your pardon?
Both his daughters married, though. He lives in a nice house. He travels. And what was he before? A Quaker.
Excuse me?
A Quaker. I know that you people don't like to get married. But since our daughters are such good friends, I want to tell you that I have always admired you. I mean, you were always on time to all those parent-teacher meetings. Well, not that you and I both are as smarter than all those teachers combined. But all the other months would come in late with the Louis Vuitton bags and the manicures, but you, the only one who had something else important to do, you were always on time.
Thank you.
What are you thanking me for? You worked very hard. We both worked very hard. That's why we put out such nice products. Do you remember that girl, Cynthia Peterson?
This is Talia Kaplan Singleberry at Sesame Street. Could you come in and see us next week? 288-788-22. Thank you. JD, it's Harriet. Would you do me an enormous favor? Would you invite him to dinner tomorrow night? Paul Stewart will be there. Don't ask. I love him.
Bye.
creed in this car. And I promised myself that in a month from now, I would not be traveling in this car with Marty. And it was just as I thought that, and honestly, I almost pushed open the car door. Then I found myself kissing his hand and saying, Marty, I love you. I don't know.
I don't know either. Maybe Lillian is right. Life is much easier without relationships.
Harry, do you think I should live with Marty?
Well, if you live with him, you won't have to wonder who will hold you at night, or what will happen to you if you don't pay your taxes, or even if you want children who you could possibly get to be the father. You won't read single women's magazines, their articles, and think of 50 different reasons why you're different from them. You won't notice younger men on the street, or say to yourself, I'm not really hurting a married man's wife if I have an affair with him, because if it's not me, it'll be someone else. But Janie, how could I sleep next to a man as nice as Marty and lie to him and tell him you love him?
I do love him. Maybe I'm just frightened.
I thought we had a pact. There is nothing wrong with being alone. We can wait until it's right. How's Mrs. Rosen?
She died. Just kidding.
My friend Joe Stein, the headhunter? Maybe we could take Mrs. Rosen with us.
Actually, I can't stay for dinner. The hospital wants me back in a half an hour. Who's Joe Stein?
Some friend of Harry's. I never met
him. I think I got whiplash in the cab ride down here.
Oh, are you all right?
Goddamn taxi driver went over a pothole. I tell you, there's no way to get around the city safely anymore.
Do you want Marty to have a look at your neck?
It's not my neck, it's my left arm. Oh my God, maybe I'm having a heart attack.
Really, I don't like having a look at it.
Marty's a resident in Mount Sinai.
Nice meeting you.
This is Janie
Glover. The only other possibility, my doctor says, is that I've been taking too many amateur massages.
Paul, how about a drink?
I better not with this neck thing. I can recommend a chiropractor.
Mother's a dancer? What company is she with?
She's an independent.
A sweet gherkin? Paul, do you remember that TV commercial we saw? Well, Marty's father was the one who was giving away the shrimp.
I loved it. Tell me, is the kid's name really Shlomo?
Shrimp on television.
I love it.
More green, Marty? How are you feeling?
Oh, I don't know. I have this sensation in my foot. Maybe this is a neurological thing.
Well, maybe.
Doesn't seem to be.
What's your specialty?
Kidneys.
The kid's name is Joe Shlomo. I love it.
You're in marketing, aren't you?
Yes, but it's too boring to talk about it.
I don't think it's boring. Have some gherkins?
Anybody seen anything good recently?
God, I haven't been to a film in ages. If I get any time, I try to read.
Did anyone read that article? Times about artificial insemination. I can imagine myself at 36, traveling cross country to inseminate myself with a turkey baster.
Turkey baster?
I'm gonna give birth to a little oven stuffer. You're not staying for dinner? There's chicken arango.
Really? I wouldn't rush off because of the whiplash.
Nice meeting both of you. Kathy! Beauty. I'm just a little tired.
Paul, I don't think we should be seeing each other anymore.
Excuse me.
I want to stop.
Will you you've been through this before.
Do you want us to get dessert?
No.
Come on, Harry. I've got this next thing. Your friends are here. We'll talk about it tomorrow. We'll have breakfast. What's the matter? Do you have your period?
See you later.
Paul is just leaving to catch up on his laundry.
You knew what the parameters were here. You're a very appealing woman. Nice meeting both of you. Thanks for helping me out with this next thing. Beauty, calm down. You're a good kid.
He's crazy. He didn't have whiplash. Harry, he is the least gracious person I have ever met. In fact, he's a real douche.
Daddy, I'm sorry.
What are you sorry for?
I shouldn't have told him about artificial insemination.
I'm going for a walk.
When are you coming back?
Janie, you sound like Tasha. I don't know when I'm coming back.
Well, this was a real nice clam bake. I'm mighty glad I came. The state's vice president, the whole day from Alice? I have no idea.
Monkey? My father wants to know if we're coming to dinner next week. The whole family will be there. My brother's anniversary.
I can't. Sesame Street called me. They want to interview me. I gotta sit home and put together some sketches for the giant bird.
So you do it next week. What?
Nothing.
What nothing?
Nothing is nothing.
Look, you want to interview at Sesame Street, fine. They do nice work. But don't let it take over your life. Don't let it take over our life. It's a real trap.
Hardy, I haven't even interviewed there yet.
You're a sweet woman. You don't want a life like that.
Like what?
I have plenty of friends who marry women doctors because they think we'll have something in common. Punky, they never see each other. Their children are brought up by strangers from the Caribbean.
That's a nice way of putting it.
I have nothing against you working. I just want to make sure we have a life.
Marty, I like my work. I may have stumbled into something I actually care about. And I don't want to do it part-time and pretend that it's real when it would actually be a hobby. But I want a life, too. Marty, my mother takes my father skating every Saturday. So I'm and that dancer struck up a partnership. I'm her daughter. I want that, too.
I made arrangements for the Sterling truck to move us to Brooklyn next Saturday.
We're going to move with a lot of shrimp and lobster tails?
What are you trying to do? Entertain me like you tried to entertain Paul Stewart?
I was just...
Look, Monkey, I'm a little bit of a nudge and you're a little bit disorganized. So if I don't make the arrangements, what's going to happen? You'll live alone or maybe meet someone who's even more of a nudge.
Marty, if I'm one of the few real people you've ever met, why do you call me Monkey?
Jesus, Jamie, I'm just trying to move us forward. See you on Saturday.
Good for you. Mother,
isolated her for the rest of her life. Do me a favor, baby. Go in tomorrow and tell your boss, whoever he is, Ron, Rick, Dick, I'm sorry, but you stole my ideas and I hold you accountable. Do you want dessert? Have some chocolate velvet cake, and I'll take a taste.
But Mother, you haven't finished not eating your lunch. You haven't picked all the salad dressing off of your salad or taken all the potatoes off of your plate.
Tom, we'll have the chocolate velvet cake.
Mother, I remember when you took me here as a little girl. And I would tell everyone in my class that I was going to the Four Seasons, because you told me it was something special. And I always loved coming here. And I always loved seeing you in your subtle blue suits, calling all those grown men, Tom, Dave. I mean, they never knew the other women in the room. But they knew my mommy. My mommy was important.
She is. Harriet, you can't blame everything on me. I wasn't home long enough for you to blame everything on me.
Clever.
I thought so. Hi, Bill.
Are you proud of me?
Of course I'm proud of you. Are you proud of me?
Yes. Harriet.
I didn't cheat you too much?
No, you didn't cheat me too much.
Baby, have children. It's one of the few things in life that's worthwhile. Hi, Kip.
Mother, when do you stop hoping that there'll be some enormous change, some dam breaking, and then you'll start living your life? Do you know what I'm tired of? I'm tired of the whole idea that everything takes work. Relationships take work. Work, personal growth takes work. Childhood, creativity, it all takes work. Well, I would like to do something simply, splendidly, that took no real effort at all.
Harriet, your thinking is all over the place today. What is it? Are you having an affair or something?
My boss's boss. The one you said should be further along, but it's not.
Harriet, 40% of the people at McKinsey are having affairs.
I know that.
See how nice it is to have a daughter in your own field? Harriet, if you want me to, I'd like to meet this guy.
No. It's all right. It's over. He had an interview with you once. He said you had balls.
Don't be offended, baby. Your father said the same thing. Hi, Ken.
Mother, do you think it's possible to have a relationship with a man? Or be married to him? Have children that you share equal responsibility for? And a career, and still read books, swim twice a week, play the piano, and have women friends.
You mean what those women magazines call having it all?
Mother, you're being too harsh.
Well, I would say that's just your generation's fantasy, Harriet.
All right. Then if you do have it all, my generation's fantasy, then what do you want?
Needlepoint. You desperately want a needlepoint. Life is a negotiation, Harriet. Do you think the women who go back to work at 36 are going to have the same job opportunities as someone who's been there since her 20s? Do you think a woman who has a baby and leaves it after 2 weeks to go back to work is going to have the same relationship with that child as somebody who's been there all along? It's impossible. And you show me the wonderful man with whom you're going to have it all. You tell me how he feels when you two take as many business trips as he does. You tell me who has to leave the office when the kid bumps their head on the radiator or slips on a milk carton. No, I don't think what you ask me is possible.
All right, when you were 29, what was possible for you?
When I was your age, I realized I had to make some important choices. I had a career, a child, and a husband. And believe me, if you have all three and you're very conscientious, you still have to choose your priorities. So I gave some thought to what was important, and what was important was a career I could be proud of and successfully bringing up a child. So the first thing that had to go was my husband, because he was a grown-up and could take care of himself. Harriet, everything did take work, but it was worthwhile. I never dreamed I'd be this successful, and I have a perfectly lovely daughter. Baby, I have a
full, rich life. What full, rich life, Mother? You like to watch the Robert File reruns every night.
If a man more appealing than James Garner comes into my life, I'll make room for him too, okay?
Well, I've made up my mind. I'm going to try to do it. Have it all.
Good for you. For your sake, I hope you can. What's the matter, Harriet? Did I disillusion you?
No. I'm afraid I'm just like you.
Don't be afraid. You're younger.
Mother, you're trying my patience.
You sound just like me, dear.
If you were younger, I would say something nasty.
Whisper it later tonight. It'll give you guilt and anxiety. Your dear old mom who's worked years to support you.
Fuck off, Mother.
Don't tell that to your boss.
Anna, pay the bill, will you, Harriet?
Comb your hair. I like it better off your face.
Anna, call me Sunday. Pretend it's Mother's Day.
Waiter, this young lady will take the check, please. I love you, Harriet.
I love you too.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Lovely lunchtime. Thank you.
Central Park to inaugurate the first annual Sterling Marathon. That's right. He's giving away spring water. He's giving away caravan. He's giving away seltzer. You know, my father always says, you should only live and be well.
Hi, Dr. Murray Schlimmelitz.
I decided to open my practice under my real name. What are you doing?
I was in the neighborhood. They accepted my sketches for the Jolly Bird. Is that a sign I know you're here?
I'm here because it's my responsibility to my family.
What's wrong?
I don't understand you. I called you all last night to coordinate the time for the moving truck to meet your house. You don't return my calls, and then you're right here ready to crack jokes. Janie, what are you, a home entertainment unit? Honey, go home. The moving truck will be at your house in an hour.
Marty. Do you ever have a feeling that everything is changing and you don't know when you decided to make the change?
Nothing's changing. I'm offering you love, I'm offering you affection, I'm offering you attention. All you have to do is put your crates that you never unpacked on the truck and get on the Belt Park Road. You just move forward.
I can't just move forward.
You know what I think? I think you're frightened to try. I think it's a compromise. I think you're not grown up enough. That's bullshit. Maybe you think I'm not special enough.
I think you're very special. But I want us to decide to move when we decide together. Marty, you took an apartment without even telling me about it first. None of it had anything to do with me. I don't want to sneak around you and pretend I'm never angry. I don't want to be afraid of you. I guess for a man I love, I want to know not just that I can talk, but that you're listening.
You think I don't listen to you?
Marty, you have all the answers before I can ask the questions.
Picked a hell of a time to bring this up. All right, if you want to give the answers, fine. Make the decision right now. If you're moving with me tonight, we stop when I'm adulting the arrangements.
Marty, by you, everything is so simple. You want a wife, you get a wife. You drop out of Harvard twice, they always take you back.
I'm so sweet, I never say what I want. And you're so sweet, you always get what you want.
Not necessarily. Why do you think I'm 32 and not married? All I want is a home, a family. Something my father makes so easily, I can't seem to get started. Why? I'm a nice Jewish doctor. Women want to marry their daughters off to me all the time. Sure, I want to know where I'll live, take the children to the nursery, but I wanted something special too. Just a little. Maybe not as special as you turned out to be, but just a little. I don't want to marry anyone like my sister-in-law.
I never liked her. Marty, I wish we could throw a wedding at the plaza, and your father could be Toastmaster General, and Harriet could select my pattern, and my mother could dance, and baby Shlomo could carry the ring in one of my father's gold seal and...
God damn it, Jane, make a decision! If you want to have children with a turkey baser, that's fine. You want to wait tickets for a giant bird at 2 o'clock in the morning, that's fine too. You want to come home to Cynthia Peterson's phone calls, that's great. You want to find out what it's like to take care of yourself, good luck to you. But it's not right for me. And I'll tell you something, Janie, it's not right for you either.
Marty, you're not right for me. I'm sorry, I can't move in with you now. If I did that, I'd always be a monkey. A sweet little girl.
I have to be back for the starting list.
It's complicated.
No! It's simple. You don't love me.
Marty!
This is Dr. Murray Schlumowitz, the first annual Sterling Marathon. Runners, get ready. On your marks, get set, go.
It's important to discuss your life choices with your friends.
Mother, you're so full of homespun advice today.
I got my hair done yesterday. I read a lot of those women's magazines. You and Joe will have to come over for some Jell-O next week.
Hi, Jane.
Hello. These are for you. Oh, I thought you'd say they're too old, they're too new.
Perfect.
How are you, Mrs. Cornwall?
Janie, you'll know me the rest of my life and you'll still call me Mrs. Cornwall. Makes you feel good, baby. The kids in the office call me Lillian and pretend we're colleagues. We're not colleagues. I'm a person of moral and intellectual superiority.
My mother feels some strength.
Speaking of strength, guess who called me? Paul Stewart. He wants you to know he really doesn't understand why you won't return his call, and he likes you very much. I'm awfully glad he has my number.
Is this your boss's boss, the one who was so impressed with my potency?
Well, he's my boss now. I was promoted.
Yay! I knew there was good news here. I got the chicken meringue message, and I knew that I know something good is happening. I've been trying to call you, but you've been busy, and then I was sending the letter B to the Bahamas. Sesame Street hired me part-time!
Yay! Perhaps I should feel threatened. I'm surrounded by achieving younger women.
Oh, I don't think Jamie's threatening to anyone. That's her gift.
Well, she is impressive. Jamie, where's your nice young man? Harriet told me he was coming over. I was looking forward to meeting him.
Marty's busy tonight.
There's a UJA testimonial dinner for his father at Szechuan Taste. One day, they'll find out which rabbi he's paying off and close down the
room. Harry, maybe Marty's father could cater your wedding. It'd be a first for the plaza and we could keep it in the family.
Excuse me?
Jane, do you remember 2 weeks ago at my whiplash party? I told you that I was driving up to a planning conference with my friend Joe Stein. He's the headhunter who got me the job at Colgate. He was a year ahead of me at Harvard. Well, I've been spending a lot of time with him recently, and yesterday he asked me to marry him.
What?
I'm going to marry Joe Stein.
He'll be all right for a first husband.
What?
I'm taking an art history class. Not for credit. Your mother is broadening herself. Well, I'll leave you two to your dinner. Harry, for the sake of your marriage, move beyond chicken Marengo.
My God. She's in a good mood.
She's been reading Red Book. So what do you think?
It's wonderful.
I want to marry him, Jamie. He's the first person in a long time who's even cared about me. He listens to me. Tosh is right. You and I deserve a little nachos.
Nachos.
Joe makes me feel like I have a family. I never had a family. Well, I mean, I had you, and I had Lily. But I never felt I could have what other women just assumed they would get.
I want to know one thing. I want to know, when I asked you about my living with Marty, you told me you didn't respect women who didn't learn to live alone and pay their own rent. And then, the first chance you had to change your life, you grasped it.
Marrying Joe is such a chance that came along.
I see. And you've been waiting for some man to come along and change your life. And all the things you told me about women and friendship, that was all so much social nonsense. I feel like an idiot. I make choices based on an idea that doesn't exist anymore.
What choices?
Never mind.
Jamie, when I told you that, I didn't know what it would be like when Paul Stewart would leave at 10 o'clock to go home to Kathy. And I would have to pretend I wasn't hurt. I didn't know what it would be like to go out to lunch with Lillian and think to myself I'm on my way to watching the Rockford Files. Of course you should learn to live alone and pay your own rent, but I didn't know what it would be like when I became too good at it. Jamie, I know how to come home, put on the news, have a glass of wine, read a book, and call you. What I don't know is what to do when there's someone who loves me in the house.
I can throw this table at you.
Why, Jamie, we're too good friends for you to be jealous.
I'm not jealous.
Well, don't blame me for your doubts about Marty.
Harriet, I don't blame you for anything. I'm sorry. Right now, I just don't like you very much.
Why? Because I'm leaving you? Because I'm getting married?
Because our friendship didn't mean very much to you. You bought me the sugar, the bread, and the salt, and you stand there and tell me you never had a family. Harry, did you ever listen to me? And you never told me how you felt. And that's sad.
Jamie, I love you. But you want us to stay girls together, and I'm not a girl anymore. I'm almost 30. And I'm alone.
You lied to me.
I didn't lie to you. I lied to myself. Jamie, it doesn't take any strength at all to be alone. It is much harder when there's someone also. children and get on with my life.
What do you do? Fall in love with every current the tide pulls in? Women should live alone, put off marriage, establish a vertical career track. So you do that. Then all of a sudden, Time magazine announces, guess what, girls, it's time to have it all. Jacqueline Smith is married and pregnant and playing Jacqueline Kennedy. Everyone else who was analyzing stocks last year is analyzing layettes this year. So you do that. What are you doing, Harriet? Who the hell are you? Can't you conceive of some plan, some time management scheme you made up for yourself? Can't you take a chance?
I am taking a chance. I hardly know this man.
Harriet, you don't have to force yourself into a situation, a marriage, because it's time.
Janie, you're just frightened of being with someone. You're just frightened of making a choice and taking responsibility for it.
That sounds romantic.
That's life.
Harriet, you are getting married to a man you've been dating 2 weeks. I am much more afraid of being alone than you are. But I'm not going to turn some man into the answer for me.
Then you'll be alone.
Then I'll be alone. I gotta go. I gotta get up early with the letter B. If they like this, they'll hire me full-time, in charge of consonants.
Give my love to Marty.
I can't. I told him I wouldn't move with him to Brooklyn.
So you got an apartment in New York?
We broke up! I decided not to see him anymore.
Won't you miss him?
I missed him today when I saw someone who looked sweet like him. And I'll miss him again late tonight.
Why don't you call him?
No.
Life is a negotiation.
I don't believe I have to believe that.
Janie, it is too painful not to grow up.
It's not the way I want to grow up.
You don't have to separate from me. I'm not leaving you.
You want me to throw this out for you?
Sure.
You really think someone has ever met anybody taking out the garbage?
They seem to like me.
to give her the package and let's go. Your father said Jamie should look like a model in this.
Don't keep it unless you like it.
Would you give your father a little pleasure and try it on?
I think it's very nice to your face. The girls are wearing the sleeves short now.
I see girls your age wearing this to walk the baby carriage.
Don't say you like it unless you like it.
I like it, I like it. If I was 36 and married to a doctor, this would be perfect.
So why aren't you?
Do you really want to know why I don't call you? You expect me to pick up the phone and say, hello, mother, hello, father. Here I am in my mink coat. I just came back from wearing it to walk the carriage. Everything is fine. Everything is wonderful. Here are your nachos.
Why do you speak so much Yiddish? We never spoke so much Yiddish around the house.
Look, I'm sorry. Things just didn't work out the way you planned. There is nothing wrong with that life. It just isn't mine right now.
Sit. Relax. What are you getting so emotional about? Look at me. I never get so emotional. All we did was buy you a coat. You'll wear it when it's cold. And if you like, you'll wear it when it's hot like those old ladies in Miami. So that's all. No big deal. Your eyes are glossy. Are you taking drugs?
You know, Jamie, I'll never forget as a child. What did I say to the hell in the room sign charm school, huh? And you always came in late with the head hanging down and the hair in your eyes. And Mrs. Rubenstein told me that you were an ungrateful child.
Mrs. Rubenstein never told you I was an ungrateful child.
Simon, what did she tell us?
The receptionist and Helena Rubenstein told you I was an ungrateful child. Mother, what do you want from me? You give me a mink coat, and I know you think any other daughter would appreciate this. Helena Rubenstein knows any other daughter would appreciate this. Georgia Klinger's daughter would appreciate this. I am a selfish, spoiled human being. Something is the matter with me.
Something is the matter. Simon, I have to go dance. I have to work for Adam's.
Honey, relax.
I don't know how I can help you understand what I'm doing. Neither of you ever lived alone. You never thought maybe I won't have children, and what will I do with my life if I don't?
All right, you're the smart one, I'm the stupid one. I haven't taught you anything.
Mother, think about it. Did you teach me to marry a nice Jewish doctor to cook chicken for him? You order up breakfast from a Greek coffee shop every morning. Did you teach me to go to law school and get a job that I sort of like every day from 9 to 8? You run out of here in leg warmers and tank tops to dancing school. Did you teach me to lie to the man I live with and say I love you when I wasn't sure? You live with your partner. You walked out to work every morning.
Now I understand. Everything is my fault. Let's go, honey. You don't have to call us. You don't even have to let us know how you are. You do what you want.
Wait a minute.
That's okay. I'm a model woman too, you know. I have my dancing. I have your father and my beautiful grandchild and man. I don't need you to fill up my life. I'm an independent woman, a person in my own right. Am I right, Simon?
Jamie, as for me, all I want is some Sunday before I come over here with a chair or a mink coat. You'd call me up and say, Dad, I want to see you.
She doesn't want to see us.
I do want to see you. And you don't have to call me every morning and sing sunrise, sunset. And you don't have to come over with a mink coat or a chair or even a Russian taxi cab driver to clean your house.
Whatever happened to him, he was a nice boy.
You just got to trust me a little bit. I believe a person should have a little originality, a little, you know, otherwise you just grow old like everybody else.
But honey, if I sit, who's going to dance?
Everything presses itself out.
Unfortunately, Jamie, the clock has a funny habit of keeping on ticking. I just want to know who's going to take care of you when not hands anymore.
I guess I will.
Don't worry, Mother. I know. I'm Tasha's daughter. I am. That's right. I am.
And Jeannie, from a man's point of view, the next time somebody wants you to make him chicken, you say I was at my sister-in-law Christ's house for the day and sure enough, lamb chops and Madison Delton testament. How hard is it to cook lamb chops? You just stick them into the boiler. If Christ can cook lamb chops, and she's a girl from Nebraska, you don't have to make anybody chicken. Believe me, you were born to order off.
Sounds like manifest destiny.
I have your number. We can have a family dinner right now.
No, Simon. Let's go home.
Goodbye, Jim.
Goodbye, Johnny. Goodbye, honey.
Oh, Mother, one more thing. Take that from me.
Fits me perfectly.
Fits you perfectly.
Where's my partner?
And there was a picture of an eligible man.